Hey, I'm Duncan from Enphase Energy, and I work in technical training. Now, I enable solar professionals like you to understand the requirements of Enphase systems and provide you with the technical support for installation best practices. In this short video, I will give you the most efficient installer toolkit app workflow to complete fast and efficient commissioning. To begin commissioning an Enphase system, you will require the following items. You will need your own Enphase Enlighten account, and you can set this up via the Enphase website. You'll also require a smartphone or tablet with the Enphase Installer Toolkit app. Now, you can download this for free from the App Store or Google Play. You'll also need to access internet on your device. And as you're going to connect the Envoy to your customer's internet, you can easily connect via Ethernet cable. But if you choose the Wi-Fi option, you will need your customer's Wi-Fi password for their modem. And lastly, you need to turn on the Envoy and confirm that it's ready for commissioning. The Envoy powers up the LEDs and they will flash red for a couple of minutes. The microinverter circuit with Q relay must also be turned on, and you'll see the LED on the Q relay turn green. And don't forget to confirm that your rooftop AC isolator is switched on. We're now ready to commission, so open up your app and follow the screen prompts to log in. Go to settings to confirm Envoy software and grid profiles are up to date. Confirm that the auto download and all buttons here are turned on. Now go to the support tab, look for the video library. You can view all of the commissioning stages here, and if you ever get stuck, simply return to this video library. You'll find what you're looking for and be back in action in no time. Now let's get stuck in and begin commissioning. Return to the systems tab. Now press the pass button on the bottom right. This app requires you to move from one stage to the next once the previous stage has been completed. So let's begin with system details, stage 1. Complete all the required fields. You'll need the customer's information as well as their email. Complete the details. And now that we've finished system details, let's go ahead and complete the next stages. Notice that stage 1 is completed and green. Now go on to stage 2. In stage 2, you're programming the Envoy with microinverter serial numbers. I will show you a simple method for quick scanning of these microinverters. Enter the correct number of devices. Select power line scan for devices. Now you'll need to add the Envoy serial number. There are two ways to do this. Manually type the serial number in or scan it. Here I'm scanning the serial number. And here's a pro tip for you. Make the serial number easier to access and peel off the serial number sticker and fix it to the front of the Envoy. If you attempt to scan, you'll be asked to connect to AP mode. To connect to AP mode, short press the top button of the Envoy. Note the LED, second from the top, is now solid green. This is the access point or AP mode. The Envoy Wi-Fi is now activated. So go into your phone's Wi-Fi settings and select Envoy Wi-Fi. Now go back and scan for devices. Scan completed. This stage is optional, and for the purpose of commissioning a system, you can simply skip to stage 4. We need to program the Envoy Wi-Fi settings. You can see there is a phone, Envoy, and internet showing connection status on the screen. Look for the customer's Wi-Fi connection. Enter their Wi-Fi password, then connect. Now once connected, confirm the Envoy LED has now changed to solid green. You may also notice that it flashes from red to green a couple of times while it is testing this connection. You can see this screen shows start provisioning devices. Press this button and you'll start updating the microinverters and Q relay with grid profiles. We're now in a great place. Provisioning is complete. Press done and we can check out the next stages. You can see on stage 5, provisioning is already completed. We are now in a critical commissioning stage, stage 6. We need to take a bit of extra care here as the app gives us feedback on if we have correctly connected the CT metering. Select production CTs and the number of phases. Select No, I'm an expert. You'll bypass the wizard and go straight to the CT commissioning stage. Now, if you're unsure and you need more guidance, please select the wizard option. The production CT arrows point away from the solar. If you have the incorrect CT readings, you may not be able to complete commissioning successfully. So look at the data. What is the screen telling you? The CT is showing power, VA, current, AC voltage, and power factor. Now I'm going to stop here and think for a moment. I have two microinverters, so I can confirm that the current and the power reading match what I expect to see. Also, is the reading positive or negative? If it is negative, recheck the connections and CT wiring. Also refer to the Enphase CT tech brief located on the Enphase website for more information. Now do not proceed with the commissioning until you are confident the CTs are correctly positioned. Now that you are 100% confident, enable production meter. And now the job is done. Now let's get into consumption CTs. These are trickier, so pay close attention. Select No, I'm an expert. You may choose to select Wizard for additional step-by-step instructions. Consumption type. Be sure to select the correct option. Load with solar will be your choice for your installations, as the consumption CT will be positioned line side of the main switchboard, so it can measure the load and also measures the exported solar value. Ensure the CT arrow faces away from the supply towards the switchboard. Be sure to confirm your readings. I recommend to test the current with a multimeter and also confirm with the app the readings. Are your readings valid? Now let's do a quick test and confirm this. Turn on and off the loads in the home. Do the measurements on your screen reflect this? Now turn off the solar. This load shows around 200 watts when I turn it on. Is this an import or export? Confirm on the screen. Now turn off the load and view 0 watts. Is the reading correct and does it reflect the changes to the load? You can swipe down on your screen to refresh this data. You do need to have the CTs correct in order to read the data and also for the system to be able to control system export if it is required. So again, please take your time here and confirm 100%. Now turn the solar back on, enable the consumption meter. Now review the app screen, we're nearly there. Look at your Envoy, what is the LED status? You want to see green, 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 and green. And we can now be confident that your system is commissioned. Before we leave, let's go into stage 7, review the system summary, review the details, and make sure that everything is looking perfect. All steps are green and completed. Now go back to your homepage on the app, and the final task is to check that the cloud indicator is green and you can ensure the site details of the app are synchronized to the internet. Let's disconnect from Envoy AP mode by turning off Wi-Fi. System is now synchronizing. As we haven't built the arrays in commissioning step 2, the system is at stage 3, so this task still needs completing in Enlighten Manager. Now your customer will automatically be emailed by Enlighten to open up their monitoring. This will happen 24 hours after you've completed all of the commissioning stages successfully. You can continue to monitor the system performance on Enlighten Manager. And that is your pro commissioning completed. Thank you for watching and all the best with your next installation.